Welcome to Adobo Nation. Ako po si Carmina.
At ako naman po si Mishy.
Tingnan mo nga naman, hindi natin namalayan. Burr na pala. Which can only mean one thing.
A burr, a burr, a burr. Let me guess. Nagpapatutog na sila ng Christmas carol sa radyo sa Pilipinas.
Nakakatawa ka.
Inusay-masay.
Translation po. Huwag kayong magtaka. Mishy isn't speaking in tongues yet. There's a reason why she greeted you in Japanese. Ito pa.
Hi, so that's na Kamina-san. Kasi ang susunod nating kwento ay tungkol sa sikat na Pinoy-owned Japanese restaurant in LA called Kazuyo.
Yun, sorry. Sikat po talaga ang Kazuyo dahil puntahan ito ng mga Hollywood stars kasama ng mga paparazzi na sumusunod sa kanila. Pero the story goes deeper, ha?
In fact, it goes all the way into a love story. Ah. O, di ba? Haluan mo pa yan ng American dream. Hmm. Pero lahat ng ito nagsimula sa Mexico.
Sandali, may Japan na, may USA pa, tapos may Mexico pa. Naging diba? International na yan. Mabuti pa, ipakwento na lang natin yan.
Itadakimasu.
Ayun. Yun na nga.
O, di ba?
On the Melrose Strip lies a small Filipino-owned Japanese restaurant, Kazuyo, a play on the Filipino word for kasuyo, or together, serving fusion-style food with a hint of Pinoy flavor, the likes of Ryan Seacrest, Katy Perry, and Filipino-American Hollywood heavyweight Dean Devlin are regulars. But underneath the rice and wraps is a love story and the struggle for the American dream. The dream started 15 years ago. Angie was in Los Angeles, pregnant and studying to be a nurse. Her husband Joe was in Mexico, trying to find a way to be with his then-pregnant wife. Against all odds, they had to be together. Joe crossed the Mexican border with only the clothes on his back.
Nag-cross ako na borderline sa Mexico to San Diego about 2 nights and 3 days. And yun, nakarating sa Amerika na safe.
Finally in the U.S. with his pregnant wife, Joe worked a series of odd jobs as a janitor, beeper salesman, and restaurant worker. He eventually landed work at a Japanese restaurant where he discovered a talent for making sushi.
Na-meet ko yung isang Pilipina na naglilinis ako sa labas. Tapos ni-interview nila ako. As yun na nag-start mag-trabaho sa kitchen. I started the kitchen na sa salad and to grill. And then nagkaroon ng opportunity magpunta sa sushi. So, doon ako nagsimula mag-ano sushi. 2 weeks time, nagkaginagawa ako ng sushi by myself.
That talent landed him a work visa at the upscale Yamashiro as an executive chef. He has since become a legal resident and will be getting his U.S. citizenship soon. After 10 years of working for different restaurants, he and his wife decided to take another risk.
Ayoko talaga, secondary recession, it's not really good for us, blah, blah, pero sanya, no, I feel that this is it. This is my dream, let's do it together.
Kazuyo not only described Joe and Angie's relationship, but also the food they serve. Sushi such as the Kazuyo roll, a combination of Joe and Angie's favorite seafoods wrapped in cucumber. And for the adobo lovers, they have the seared garlic albacore sashimi.
Sa ngayon, sa year na to, like 2000, kailangan natin mag-create ng some fusion style na pinaghahalo ko yung American, Filipino, and Japanese cuisine sa plato.
We use the Filipino soy sauce, not the Japanese or American soy sauce, because it tastes different and not as good as our Filipino soy sauce.
Their popularity is growing. Since opening less than 2 years ago, Kazuyo is ranked as the 4th best sushi restaurant by MyFox LA and was given a Talk of the Town award by Celebration Media US. With the support of the community and its star-studded clientele, Kazuyo stands as a symbol of the American dream that Chef Joe and Angie achieved together.
We feel like we're just starting in this restaurant, but we're very thankful, of course, to God. Every single step we make in our lives, from the time that we start our relationship ang dami ng milagro. So up to now, talagang miracles happening pa rin sa aming dalawa, sa aming family.